श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। Except in India, everywhere we require qualifications to attain something. See? In India, we don't require qualifications. Rather, qualifications are disqualifications. When you are unfit for everything, you are fit for everything. So here, where we will be studying Vedanta, we require some basic qualifications. Without qualification, if we do something, it ends up into a mess in one's own life. Therefore, to know Sat, Chit, Ananda and beyond, we also require some qualifications. But normally what happens, when it comes to the spiritual life, we understand spirituality is for those who are unfit for everything. So we get into spirituality when we are extremely old, dilapidated, we can't hear anything, we want to hear, we don't remember anything. Did I take my lunch? You took 4 times since morning, my dear. Okay, don't scold. Scold, I forgot. Then we want to remember the Gita. When we cannot sit in one posture for more than 3 seconds, we want to sit for meditation. Therefore, this notion that spirituality is possible for any Tom, Dick and Harry must be removed from our mind. Why I am emphasizing this? This happened in Allahabad many, many years before. That time I was pretty young. And somebody's house I went for food. That is my professional hazard. So I went to somebody's house for food. And when the table was laid, we went and sat. And there one huge sun, 6+4+, standing like Vivekananda. So I told him, I said, hey, come on, join. You take. And anyway, I came for that only. So the mother of the child felt very bad. Swamiji, he is such a useless one. I am fed up of him. He doesn't study. He doesn't work. Whole day he eats my head and food. And creates problem for everyone. I don't know what to do. He is good for nothing. As if that was a chutney along with food. Thereafter she said, Swamiji, why don't you take him to your ashram? See, how simple it is. That means those who are good for nothing, they are fit for spirituality. So I told, I said, my mom also sent me like that. See, friends, Upanishad tells, Nayam Atma Balahinena Labhya. The truth is not for those who are good for nothing. It is not for those who are dropouts in life. It is not for those who are failures in life. It is not for those who are mental wrecks. See, many places we come across this wrong understanding. Meditation for peace. On the contrary, if you are in peace, then only you can do meditation. See, it is something like, you know, weight lifting for spondylosis. Therefore, let us have this clear understanding. To understand these 4 topics, Sat, Chit, Ananda and beyond, we require qualification. And if we are able to comprehend it as it is revealed, then we are qualified. And if we are not able to understand a word, then it is God's grace which will come sometime or the other. It will not go waste. Upanishad, Avadhuta Gita probably tells very clearly, Ishvara anugrahat eva pumsam advaita vasana mahat bhaya paritranat vipranam upajayate. Vipranam upajayate, those who are qualified, they alone have inkling or liking for knowing the truth. See, because here perseverance is required. We have to apply daily. See, friends, when we go to see a drama or a circus, we go only once. You can't repeat it every day. See, the same circus, you know, I have seen 20 times. Then you must have fallen in love with one of the girls. See, there is no other way. Because it cannot attract our mind for long. But when it comes to study of scriptures and recognition of our correct identity, we require commitment and we require perseverance, we require full involvement. And the most important thing is, spiritual life is not a part-time profession. See? In yoga, you can do that. I'll tell you one of my experience in yoga. This happened somewhere in Germany, I think. Germany or Sweden, somewhere. We had 3 days, workshop on meditation and yoga. So, morning session is over, then there is a little break, about an hour, and I used to go for a nice walk and come back. And after that, second session. After that, go home. 2 sessions in the morning. And after my walk is over, I come back, and then we'll sit for meditation. Everybody was liquid spiritualist. Everybody was throwing the fragrance of beer. All the bottles were emptied and the drums were filled. And they don't have to do anything. It is natural Shambhavi Mudra. See? And to them I had to talk about meditation. Therefore, spiritual life is not a part-time profession. We have to live every moment. Like health, he is not a part-time profession. See, morning I don't take rice, but at night I eat 1 kilogram of ice cream. So morning dieting, evening die eating. See, that is not the way. So we have to be committed all the time. Just to get some kind of support to talk on this topic, in the afternoon, I was sleeping. See, that is the time when I am in meditation. After food, you go to sleep. It's such a great fun. So, there I was told, you take this Tattva Bodh and elaborate on this topic. Vasudevendra Yogindram Natva Jnana Pradam Gurum Mumukshunam Hitarthaya Tattva Bodho Vidhiyate. Bhagavad Shankaracharya says, Mumukshunam hitarthaya. There are 2 things. One is what is good for us. And the second thing is what do we like? 2 things. What we like may not be good for us. And what is good for us, we may not like it. See? For example, getting up early in the morning. Can't you give some other example? This is the only example. In one of my lecture series, one lady came. And she told me, Swamiji, please don't give that example of getting up early in the morning. Whenever I listen to your lecture, I feel guilty. Every day I get up 8 o'clock, 10 o'clock. See? So, getting up early in the morning we don't like, but that is good for us. So, mumukshunam hitarthaya, those who want to bless themselves. फॉर देम तत्वबोधो भी दीयते दिस तत्वबोध इज बीइंग एलाबरेटेड एंड मुमुक्षुणाम हितार्थाय हु इज ए मुमुक्षु मुमुक्षु इज अ वन हु हैज रिकग्नाइज हिज ओन लिमिटेशंस एंड वॉन्ट टू ट्रांसेंड दिस लिमिटेशंस एंड कम टू डिस्कवर द ब्लिसफुल एक्सपीरियंस 24/7 ही इज मुमुक्षु सो फॉर देयर बेटरमेंट तत्वबोध देर आर टू वर्ड्स वन इज तत्व ज्ञान सेकेंड इज तत्व बोध तत्व ज्ञान इज एट द लेवल ऑफ माइंड इन पंचदशी समवेयर एवन श्लोका कम्स विच टेल्स देर वॉज एन अनाउंसमेंट ही हु नोज फोर वेदास विल बी गिवन $10,000 सो वन पर्सन गोज गिव मी वाय आई नो वॉट फोर वेदास देर आर फोर वेदास दैट्स इट गिव मी नो तत्वबोध इज एक्सपीरियंस इट इज नॉट एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ समथिंग वी हैव एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ ईटिंग वी हैव एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ स्लीपिंग we are experience of tragedies we are experience of joy we are not talking experience of experience itself is called a bodha tatva bodha that experience where knowing and being is one is called as bodha and that experience where Knowing must be followed by action is tattva jnana. Like, if you chant Gayatri Mantra 2400,000 times, because there are 24 letters, for each letter 100,000 times. If you chant that, you will get The Brahma Tej. So you heard it. Knowledge you have got. Now, is there any way somebody I can employ? People do that. They have to do the Mrityunjay Mahamantra. So they employ the Panditji. Panditji, do for me Mrityunjay Mahamantra. Okay, said ji. Dakshina? You people are very greedy all the time, money, money, money. Look at us, we are said ji without greed. Okay, take this savva rupiya. And when that 1 rupee 25 paise is given, and said ji turns, Panditji says, said ji, it's done. It is done so fast. Did he do SMS or what? So the Pandit ji says, Sava rupaye mein aise hi hota hai. You can employ for these things, somebody can do puja for you, somebody will do japa for you. But here, there is no proxy on the spiritual path. We have to live our life, we have to die our death, We have to practice our own spiritual life. Don't have that notion. Guru, huh, utao. Mule guru will utao. See, therefore, tattva bodha is that experience where knowledge does not demand follow-up action. Where knowledge is being. Where knowing and being merge into one, that is Tattva Bodha. So this is what we are going to tell you. Okay. Now, the teacher says, it is not for anybody, but for whom sadhana chatushtaya sampanna adhikarinam moksha sadhana bhutam tattva viveka prakaram vakshamaha. So this is for those who are qualified with fourfold qualifications. Now question, which are the fourfold qualification? Viveka, Vairagya, Shamadhi, Shataka Sampatti and Mumukshutva. force. See? So the first qualification is Viveka. Viveka is what? Viveka is the ability to discriminate between the eternal and ephemeral. See? Every word will be revealing the truth. Only thing, we are available or not. Truth is available. We are not available to the truth. See? Eternal and changing. Discrimination between eternal and changing is Viveka. Now find out what is changing and what is not changing. Somebody told me just now, Swamiji, you are the same, you never change. See? So there is one principle which has never undergone any change. There is another principle which is constantly changing. Discriminate between the two and find out whether you are the changing principle or the unchanging reality. You have discovered the truth. See? I speak few words in different tones. The tone is changing. Sri Ram, Sri Ram, Sri Ram. Changing. But the silence which was separating them remained unchanged. Further, sound and silence are opposite to each other. But there is one principle which supports the sounds as well as the silence. And therefore, it is beyond the sound and the silence. In a fraction of moment, truth is revealed. See, friends, that is what I say. Truth is available. But are we available to the truth? So this is Viveka. Then comes Vairagya. Now what is the Vairagya? Vairagya iha amutra phala artha phala bhoga viragaha. Vairagya is wherein there is a complete disregard to the enjoyment of anything in this world as well as in the other world. Whatever we do or not do for getting happiness. All our actions are, or withdrawal from the actions is prompted by only one thing, and that is for getting happiness. Why we want to get happiness? Because we are bankrupt as regards the bliss is concerned. So what will be vairagya, viraga, dispassion? Dispassion will be, we are no more seeking happiness. How simple it is. In a school I was talking in Goa. I was extremely not well. So morning, evening lecture I used to have. I said, don't fix any other lecture, okay? So they will do whatever they want and I had to obey. Only for the namesake I am Swami, but I had to just obey. So, Swamiji, but we are fixed, you know, then what will happen to Amare Naak Kat Jayegi? I said, Myra, throat katega uska kya? So I had to go. I went. I said, okay, keep one classroom and one group of children. Class 8, 9, 10, one group. Okay, Swamiji. And when I went there, the whole school was there. About 700-800 children. And they were sitting in row. Now Swamiji has come. Let us welcome him, clap and bhajan kirtan all over. Now Swamiji speak to them. Now how to talk, you tell me. This side, children from KG1, KG2. In between, children from, you know, class 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. This side, class 9, 10, 11. Now, to whom to address? when I start talking, dear children, when you see this kind of face, you can't talk. See? And when you look this side, they are only eating nails. So, I thought, you know, there is no point in talking. So, let me play with them. I said, hey, all of you, good morning. Shall we play some game? When game comes, everybody is equal. Yes. I said, okay. Now, those of you who want happiness, raise your hands. One hand per head. Don't raise two hands. Almost all the children is happiness. Very good. Hands down. Is there someone who doesn't want happiness? One child from maybe class 3, 4 and one girl from class 10. There is hands. One boy, one girl. I said, oh, really? No, you don't want. You come here. When I called them on the stage, they are feeling very bad. I think we have done some mistake before everybody Swamiji has called us. They came as a big sofa, sit with me. I said, now our game continues. You tell me, who wants food? The one who is hungry, is it not? Yes, Swamiji, very good. You tell me, who wants water? The one who is thirsty, is it not? Yes, Swamiji. Who wants happiness? Those who are miserable. Is it not? Yes. I said, you are all miserable. And these two kids, they are not miserable. Therefore, they don't want happiness. See how simple it is. All that we do in our life is to get happiness. And because of this, Kurute Ganga Sagara Gamanam Vrata Paripalana Vatha Vadanam. When we give in charity, so that when I go up there, they will say, kitna diya tha? Charana, udar jao. Till such time we are seeking happiness, we are not on the spiritual path. Have courage to accept it. We go to the temple. For what? Telling God in clear terms. Listen, we don't want you, okay? You are the means. And the goal of our life is happiness. See? So we go and sign an MOU. God kindly note down, you have all energy, no desires. We have got all desires, no energy. Let us sign an MOU so that your energy and my desires can become good partners. And I am able to enjoy and fulfill my life. Our spirituality is only a bargain in exchange of happiness. Viraga, vairagya means don't seek happiness. Then, distribute happiness. See? If I have got peanuts in my pocket, how can I distribute cashew nuts? So what is meant? To distribute happiness, we have to first discover happiness. Discover means what? It is there. But it is covered by ignorance, incomplete knowledge. Discover. And once you discover, you will naturally distribute. See? Like you go and see some movie. And you really like that movie. So don't you tell your friend, say, come on, see, it's a very good movie. In the same manner, he who has discovered the happiness, he alone can distribute happiness. Therefore, a dispassionate person is always happy. So Viveka gave you bliss. Vairagya is also a technique by which the bliss is freely available, distributed. Then Shamadi Shataka Sampatti, the third qualification. Shama is control over mind. See. Virajya Vishaya Vrata Dosha Drushtya Murmuhu Swalakshe Niyata Vasta Manasaha Shama Uchyate. Bhagavan says in Vivek Chudamani, when we have got some negative points about something, we discard it. Like, you know, we go and buy a cigarette packet. I don't know here, I buy only in India. So there it is written, cigarette smoking is injurious to health. What for it is written? So that we may not buy it. It is injurious to health. But now that becomes an authentication. Oh, it is written, then it is a good cigarette. Give one more. See? So when we discover something wrong with something, we stop indulging with that. And when we stop indulging with the worldly things and beings, manasaha shama uchyate, now the mind is at peace and available to us. First qualification, among the sixfold spiritual wealth. Then dama, dama is the control over the sense organs. Shama was control over the mind, dama is control over the sense organs. Many times we sit for taking food, take some more, no, I don't want to take sweet, no, but I prepared with such a great love for you and this is the first time I prepared. That means you are a guinea pig, eat. Many ammas do experiment on me, therefore I am telling you. They prepare things for the first time. There was one patient, he was going for the operation. He was shivering. Lying on that operation table, and he told the doctor, Doctor Saab, this is my first operation. I'm extremely afraid. Please help me. He said, look at me, man. I'm not afraid. This is mine also first operation. So, dama is control over the sense organs. Shama, dama. Then, uparati. Uparati is effortless withdrawal from anything in this world. Effortlessness. This example will make it clear. See, if our car is like this, you apply the brake and the brake gets applied after 10 minutes. What will be the condition? When we apply the brake, that very moment it must stop. In the same manner, uparati is effortless withdrawal from the world. Effortless. Shamadamur uparati shraddha. Next one. Shraddha is a positive creative thinking. Shraddha is always blind. Faith is always blind. Many people have got this funny notion that I don't have blind faith, faith is always blind. We don't require faith when we know something. When we don't know, then we require faith. We have faith that this lady is my mother. We don't know where we will drop in this world. Somebody tells us, this lady is your mother. And then that lady tells, this man is your father. 100% faith. Therefore, shastrasya guru vakyasya satya buddhyavadharana sa shraddha kathita sadbihi yaya vastu upalabhyate. What is said in the scriptures, what is taught by the teacher, how that is right, this positive approach is called a shraddha, and by this alone the truth is revealed. Shraddhavan labhate jnanam tatparaha sayate indriyaha, Gita says. Then titiksha, the fifth one. Titiksha is sahanam sarvadukkhanam apratikara purvakam chinta vilap rahitam sa titiksha nigadyate. Titiksha is going through the difficulties of life with a smile on the face and confidence in the heart. No complaint. Titiksha means living at a zero complaint level. See, try this. Stop complaining about anything or anybody on any issue. Then what we will do? See? When we don't have anything to complain, then we have got God, poor God, available freely. Duniya banane wale kahe ko duniya banai? Why did you create this world? Just to trouble you. Therefore, titiksha is sarvadukkhanam apratikar purva sahanam. Don't retaliate, don't reject. Go through the life without reaction. No impression will be formed on the mind. See, friends, Titiksha is a technique by which we protect us from ourselves. And then the sixth spiritual wealth is Samadhana. And the five things are practiced. Shama, Dama, Uparati, Shraddha, Titiksha. And then the sixth one comes is Samadhana. Samadhana is you are at peace with yourself. If you are at peace with yourself, then only you are at peace with the whole world. A person who is at war with himself, he can never be at peace with the world. See? Once somewhere I was traveling from Calcutta to Bombay many years before, and near Nagpur area, the train, there was some accident, so our train stopped. Summer days, June, July, heavy heat, no water, no nothing. So 20 minutes, half an hour, 1 hour, 2 hours, no message, no nothing. So I was reading some book. After I got tired, I kept it and I went for a walk and again came and sat because it was very hot outside. And then there was one man with his daughter sitting. He asked me, "What do you do?" I said, "I do nothing." "Who are you?" I said, "I am Babaji. Those who do nothing, they are Babaji. I am Babaji." "You are not worried?" I said, "No, I am not worried. On the contrary, I am happy. I have paid government 36 hours for traveling, but now I am utilizing the government facilities more than 48 hours. He got so angry with me. See? "I had to get my daughter married. That is, and as if, you know, I have stopped the train." And he was scolding me. And when he was losing his sense, then his daughter said, "Dad, what are you talking? Nonsense. He has not done anything. But he is enjoying." "See, I am enjoying. Why do you suffer?" See, friends, recognize this principle. If you are at peace, you will be at peace with the whole world. And when without peace, you sit for meditation. Inside, there is a truck running without movement. And you want to sit for meditation. And that time in your bathroom, one drop of water falls on the plastic bucket. Tuck, and that is enough to upset you. I told, these people never understand. They don't tighten the tap properly. Tuck. I don't know what is to be done with this kind of people. How can you tuck? Do the meditation in this house, tuck. With every tuck, you are irritated. After some time, it stops. Kya ho gaya? No, why? It stops. Friends, if you are at peace, nothing in this world will disturb you. See, it is something like, if there is little water in a pond or something, or a bucket, you put even a dry leaf. That dry leaf is enough to create ripples on the water, is it not? But when the ocean is so deep, the whole ship sinks, no ripple. See? In the same manner, Samadhana is that experience wherein we are disturbance proof. Choice is ours. But if we are, you must have seen that shrub called as touch me not, chewy mui. You touch it? Oh. After some argument. In the same manner, somebody tells you, "You are so sweet." But you are dumb. Non-stop reactions, you know. When the sixfold spiritual wealth, we understand the material wealth in our life. Be attentive. Has anybody ever said or tried that earning money is difficult and therefore I don't want to earn money? Has anybody ever said? But when it comes to the spiritual wealth, Shama Dama Uparati Sadhati Diksha Samadhana, when it comes, oh Swami, it is very difficult, you know. Because we have not recognized the value of this spiritual wealth. The day you recognize this, it will start happening. See, when we become angry, the one on whom we become angry, nothing happens to him. We only shoot up our blood pressure. Hum gussa kar rahe, wo has rahe. See, friends, it is very simple. It's not difficult. Only thing, recognize the value of this spiritual wealth. And when we just start living with ourselves, in spite of the world, we are at peace. See, friends, then some inkling, some little bit trailer of Sat is revealed to us. See, you know, my trust is Sat Bhavana Trust, S-A-T, Bhavana Trust in Bombay. So, one Sanskrit Pandit, English speaking Sanskrit Pandit, told me, Swamiji, excuse me, I want to point out one thing. What is that? You wrote Sat Bhavana Trust. Actually, when Halanta Takar is followed by a soft consonant, the Takar is converted into Dakar and it is called as Sat Bhavana Trust, not Sat Bhavana Trust. Like Bhagavad Gita, it becomes Bhagavad Gita. Toh becomes the. I said, thank you for the suggestion and advice, but I particularly kept this thing. So why? I said, when I will write in English, what will I write? Sad Bhavana Trust. Nobody will read at Sat. They will read sad. Because that is very easy for them to understand. Sat, they can't understand. See, therefore, the sixfold wealth is essential, valuable, important in our life. Then only the Sat is revealed. Then the fourth is Mumukshutva. Mumukshutva is Moksho me bhuyat iti iccha mumukshutvam. May I be liberated from this relative existence. That intense longing is called as Mumukshutva. See? Unless the intense longing comes in our life, we will never practice spiritual life. See, friends. Swami Vivekananda once asked Bhagavan Ramakrishna Paramahams that the mother talks to you, why she doesn't talk to me? So the teacher said, because you don't have the intensity that she should talk to you. No, I have intensity. If you have, she will talk. As much I have intensity, you don't have. What do you mean by intensity? Yes, I really want. It's only changing the tone. It's not there. Then he said, okay, we'll see it later. They went to take bath in Ganges. And there, the teacher put his head below the waters. 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, how long? Afterwards, Vivekananda pushed his hand and came out of the water, breathing hungrily. Then the teacher says, as you were longing for breathing, that intense longing, if you have to seek the truth, then alone the truth is revealed. Upanishad says, Yamai Vesha Vrunute Tena Labhyaha Tasesha Atma Vivrunute Tanum Swam. Those who seek the truth to the exclusion of everything, to them alone the truth is revealed. See, it is something like, you know, your homely examples. Sometimes you must have seen a child is crying and the mother tries to avoid the child because she has to do so many things. So she will give him chocolate. If the child stops eating chocolate, she is very happy. No chocolate, then she gives some game, some toys, even then. Ultimately, the child wants nothing but mommy. Finally, the moment she takes, that is all right. Because he has rejected everything. In the same manner, when we have that capacity to reject everything to the exclusion of the reality, then alone the truth is revealed. See, friends, for us spirituality means what? I am a big sadji and I got two useless children in my lap. One is putting the ear, a finger in the ear, other in the nose. And my Sethani is standing there, huge structure, studded with gold and diamonds. And that time I am counting $1,000 notes, rupees notes. And that time if Bhagavan Krishna comes, I tell him, wait for a moment. This is how darshan we want. See, friends. Mumukshutva. Okay, moksho me bhuyat iti ichha. Now, tatva viveka prakaraha kaha. Atma satyam tad anya sarva mitheti. See, now we go slowly into sat. Atma, the self, is the sat. Rest, everything is asat. Not asat, but an appearance. Mithya means what? There are three stages in understanding. First, something is. Second, something is not. And third option is called as mithya. When I was talking to children in one of the schools, I wanted to explain them this. So I told, do you see the beard on my face? Yes, so this is. Do you see the horns on my head? No. So they are not. Asat. And one child was looking here and there. I said, now you tell me. What did other students told? Do you see the horn on my head? Not for now. Who knows? They may come up after some time. This is the third possibility. So that which is appearing but which is not is called a mithya. See? So atma satyam tat anyat sarvam mithyeti. So when we have to learn the word sat, it simply means let our attention be drawn on the substratum, the self that we are. Our attention goes on the world because it is not our fault, it is manufacturer's defect. Kathopanishad tells, I am not telling. Kathopanishad says, Paranchi khani vetruna svayambhu tasmat paran pashyati nantaratman kaschid dhiraha pratyagatma namaikshat avrutta chakshuhu amrutatva vichyan. Paranchi khani vetruna svayambhu. Paramatma created all our khani means indriyani. All our sense organs are created. Paranchi, extrovert, going out. Ancha is the dhatu. Param is out. Not pratyak. Pratyak means nearer. Param is away. So all our senses are created such that they are by default extrovert. It is something like this. When we are sitting in our eyes, we will naturally see outside. When we are sitting in our ears, we will be naturally hearing what others are talking. In deep sleep, what we do, we start closing all our sense organs. And when we close all our sense organs, then only we can enter the sleep. See? Therefore, Atma Satyam, the self is the reality, the truth. For this, what is required is, let us start focusing our attention on the self means let us stop getting involved in the external world. In one place I went somewhere, there was, my host was Jain, and after one or two lectures, he asked me this question. Swamiji, you also tell, do Atma Chintan, and our Munis come, they also tell Atma Chintan, but what is Atma Chintan? Nobody tells us. Can you tell us? I said, when you stop doing Anatma Chintan, take example. Eyes, when they are open, they will see colors and forms. When they are closed, they will not see colors and forms. Third option. Keep yourself in utter darkness. And in that utter darkness, when you can see nothing, keep your eyes open. So eyes are open, therefore seeing is happening, but nothing is seen, and therefore seer is not born. Seeing without the division of seer and seen is sadvastu. This is sad. Eyes cannot exist without colors and forms. Colors and forms cannot exist without eyes. See? But there is a factor which is independent of the objects and the sense organs which are illuminating the objects. That independent factor is called as sat. And for that, the first step spiritual practice is, where do we run away? So we run in the objective world. When can we stop running about the objective world? See, like we see the mirage waters. We see, we enjoy. But do we run after the mirage waters to quench our thirst? We don't, because we know it is an appearance, though, yet it is not. In the same manner, when our attention goes on the worldly objects, and when we come to discover the source of happiness is not the worldly objects, but we, our running around in the world will stop. See, our condition is like that dog. Such dogs you can't see in New Zealand. Such dogs you can see only in India. Because in India, the democracy is extended beyond human beings. Everybody has got freedom to be whatever he or she is, whether animal or plant or anything. So one dog, he was running around, and he found one nice big bone. So happy he was. The dogs in this place are most, you know, unfortunate. Nobody could see this such a beautiful bone. And he took it and ran in one corner and sat somewhere. And after he sat over there, then he started biting, and the sharp edges of the bone piece were lacerating his buccal cavity. And with that, blood was coming out, and he was sucking his own blood. So nice. And again, eat, you know. We are exactly like that. Be attentive. Whenever we have desire about anything in this world, that desire makes our mind disturbed. And whenever we get the object that we wanted, meaning, when the desire is fulfilled, in the fulfillment of the desire, the mind becomes quiet. Quiet mind is the source of happiness. So the happiness is not coming from outside. It is from within. But like the dog, we lacerate the mouth by indulging with the worldly objects, and then so nice. If we become aware of this phenomena, thereafter, yogaratova, bhogaratova, sangaratova, sangavihina, presence and absence of the worldly objects makes no difference. See, friends, therefore, the first step to discover the Sat, Paramatma, is the ability to withdraw from the world. And we can withdraw from the world only when we are leading our life in utter awareness. We don't do anything bad intentionally. We have no intentions. But it happens because we are not living in awareness. See, like, you know, you must have seen many houses it happens. When people, they enter the house, they don't have bad intention that their shoes should be set, kept right in the middle so that others have to jump and come. They don't have that intention. But when they enter, they leave the shoes there and get in. Why? Because not living in awareness. When two persons are talking, the third person is not required to go and poke his nose. But it is again manufacturer's defect. God has given nose to poke. Kya, 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 kya ho raha, kya? And if we don't tell them, see, I am the most unwanted furniture in the house, at least you understood it very good. They don't have any bad intentions. But the idea is they are not living in awareness. In the same manner, be very attentive. If we start living in awareness, then you will come to know that so far what we have done in our life, only one thing, if we are to write our autobiography in one line, it will be, we tried to fulfill our desires, but till now we have not discovered fulfillment in our life. Amen. That's all. And yet, we have not learned that fulfillment of desires is not equal to fulfillment in life. The day you recognize this phenomena that is happening in you, you will withdraw from the world effortlessly, although you are very much in the midst of the world. See, Padma Patra Mivambasa, Bhagavan gives an example in the Bhagavad Gita, like the lotus leaf. He's very much in the water, but the waters cannot touch the lotus leaf. See, friend. And this can happen not by any other means except living more and more in alertness, in awareness. See. But our condition is nothing to do, just simply kya karo, kya karo. Oh, it's raining. And when it is raining, then there is a podcast. In such heavy rains, if one gets a good cup of tea, what a nice thing it will be. Podcast. Okay, okay, I understood. And then a cup of tea is given. Good tea. Now what happened? Tea, raining season without pakoda. Second desire. Simple pakoda. Mirchi hai ni? There is no end, friends. Once you recognize this, that the mind does not want us to be with ourselves. So constantly sending the baits, you know, like the fish. Whether it is eatable or it is a hook, no discrimination. Whether we are getting happiness from the object that we get as a result of our desire, or we get happiness because the desire is temporarily quietened. The day you become aware of this fact, then world can never attract your mind. See, friends, Therefore, Atma Satyam Tadanyat Sarvam Mithyeti. So unless we take this stand about the world, this world is merely an appearance, it is not real. See, when we were yesterday also going in Queensland, nice drive. One thing you can very, every experience reveals the truth. Every experience. So when we are going, from a distance you see there is nothing, all darkness. But the moment your light falls on those roadside markings, immediately they are illumined. In the same manner, be very attentive. Worldly objects have no existence unless they are illumined by us. So who is the reality? The object or us? We only see the object. Then we only start projecting. And we only become the victim of our own projections. And if the object we get, we alone become happy. If we don't get, we become miserable. Where from the whole cinema started? Started from us. This is how people fall in love. Those who rise in love, this doesn't happen. See, one useless boy goes to a garden. All useless people alone can go to garden. Otherwise, who has time? And then, it's not only boys are useless, girls are equally. So the girl also goes to the garden, useless. Two useless people, unemployed, unemployable. When they look at each other, they fall in love. And they get hurt throughout life, because they have fallen. Only projections. I think, why we must have come here in this very moment, in this garden? It must be a divine providence that we are not together. And then I think we are made for each other initially. Then we are meant for each other. And there we are mad at each other. This is how the mind starts projecting. See, friends, therefore, recognize the trick of the mind and understand the basic equation. Fulfillment of desires is not equal to fulfillment in life. The first thing to be clearly understood. Then alone, sarvam mithyeti, then we come to know all that is perceived through the sense organs, all that is projected by the mind is an illusion. It is not real. See? Understand the meaning of illusion technically. Any experience which demands n number of conditions to happen, that experience falls in the purview of illusion. For example, the rainbow. If somebody comes and tells you, "Oh, Mama, I was late because when I was coming at night, you know, almost it was 10 o'clock, all darkness, and it was such a hot day, and I couldn't see anything, and I saw rainbow somehow." At night you saw rainbow? You must be dreaming then. Why? Rainbow cannot be seen any time. You require n number of conditions. Then only rainbow can be seen. Therefore, rainbow is an illusion. Now, extend this example. This waking experience that we are going through. When this experience can happen? Only when we are identified with our body. If we are not identified with our body, like it happens many times, you know. Sometimes people come for satsang and they get good sleep. So here is the only place where they get Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Everywhere is only Ashanti. See? So they come and sleep nicely, comfortably. For them, they don't feel shy if they are snoring. Because they don't belong to this world. We feel disturbed. Why? Because we are awake. Then what should you also sleep? So this waking world is possible only when we are identified with the body. The dream world is possible only when we are identified with the modifications of the mind. The deep sleep experience is possible only when we have deleted these two experiences. So all these experiences which are gathered through the sense organs, which are attained in the mind, they stand as illusions. See, friends. And all these experiences come and go, but there is one experience, and it is not the experience of. It never comes, never goes. See. Therefore, most of the old people say, I am 85 years young. They feel they have made a joke. 85 years young means what? Nobody had the experience of growth. Therefore, I have not grown. 85 belongs to the body. So it is a sabudana khichadi. The experience of non-changing, unchanging reality plus the changing body put together, I am 85 years young. In this manner, when our attention is consciously brought on our essential nature, then alone we can get rid of this worldly presence or absence. Sarvam mithyeti. Mithya does not mean it is not experience. Something could be experience, but it need not be real. Like, something is useful and yet it cannot be real. It may not be real. For example, the longitudes and latitudes on the globe, are they anywhere? They are only imaginary lines. They are useful also in pinpointing any spot, Google Maps. See? And yet they are not real. Therefore, what is mithya? That which is appearing, that which is experienced, that which is useful, and yet which is not, is mithya. Then how do we deal with this mithya world? Like we deal with on the stage as an actor. So what the actor does? The actor gives one plastic flower to the other girl and says, honey, I love you. Now he knows he doesn't love this Dumbo. And she also knows he's just a dialogue. And when the flower is given, they are told by the director, you will not get next flower, protect it properly. So she keeps it very slowly as if loving, no, it is to be used for the next show. So she's So, although it is mithya, but it is performed perfectly. Is it not exactly the same way? To deal with this mithya world that is appearing, let us live our life as an actor on the stage. Perfection, yet no status of reality. See? Like one actor comes on the stage, Chhatrapati Shivaji. That time also he knows, he is not even an ordinary pati, very Chhatrapati. But he acts so well in the same manner. This knowledge, Atma Satyam, Tad Anyat Sarvam Mithyeti, is the first step to recognize what is the Sat Vastu. Thereafter, then the teacher says that Atma kaha, what is the Atma? So the Atma is defined. Now this is a very deep topic. I am talking about Atma, that doesn't mean CH Atma. Oh, I know CH Atma. So ja rajakumari. No, not that CH Atma. Sthula, sukshma, karana, shariraad, vyatiriktaha, pancha koshatitaha, san, avasthatraya, sakshi, satchidananda, swarupaha, san, yattishtati, sa atma. This is the topic I was told to speak. Satchit ananda and beyond. See? here the word use, that what is this Atma? Atma is first sthula sukshma karana shariran vitiriktaha, the one which is other than the gross body. Gujaratis don't have gross body. All Gujaratis have gross body. Gross body and subtle body. Subtle body is the process of subtle body. And then the casual body. Causal body and the casual body. So the one who is beyond the three bodies. See? Sthula deha, gross body. Sukshma deha, subtle body. And causal body is the karan deha. So, sthula sukshma karana shariraad vyatiriktaha. Now see. With reference to these three bodies, we go through three major experiences of our life. When we are identified with the sthula deha, the gross body, then we go through the experience of this gross world called as the waking experience. In this waking experience, the objects and the words indicating the objects are different. For example, book is the word, and what is in my hand is the object. So that experience where object and the word indicating the object, they are separate. That experience is called as the sthula deha and waking experience. Then what is the subtle deha? Subtle deha is the mind. We'll come, I can tell right now. There are 17 factors which go into the formation of the subtle body, and they are 5 jnanendriyas, 5 karmendriyas, pancha pranas, and mind and intellect. These 17 factors go together to form the subtle body. The gross body, we all know, no more explanation is required. And the causal body is incomplete understanding about everything. Please remember, this word is normally erroneously translated. Ignorance does not mean absence of knowledge. Knowledge cannot be absent. When I know that I don't know Gujarati, so I know, how can I be ignorant? See, when I think that I am this body, knowing I am body is not wrong. But only this body I am and other body I am not, from here the problems begin. See, friends. So the incomplete knowledge is called as the karana sharira. And what is the meaning of sharira? Sharira means that shiryamana tvat shariram, that which can be disintegrated. So the gross body, when the pranas leave the body, the pancha mahabhutas are disintegrated. So the first, the air goes back to the total air, the heat of the body goes back to the total heat, the water of the body merges with the total water, the earth element because of which the gross aspect is constructed, that goes back to the earth element, and the shape which was occupying the space, that space is released for the next one. In this manner, when the body dies, it is all the 5 elements are disintegrated, they go back. Therefore, it is called as sharira. Similarly, the mind. The mind can survive only when it is given objectivity as its food. Mind doesn't want to die like we don't want to die. So what the mind does, same thing what we do. What we do, we keep on eating whole day. Exactly the same way. The mind eats continuously on the past memories and the future worries and the present comparisons. You stop these three things, your mind will disappear. Mind without the past and the future has to remain in the present. And when in the present, the mind doesn't compare, then the mind dies. And what remains? Presence. Presence is that where there is no present tense, past tense, future tense. And therefore, those who live as presence, they live without tensions, because they don't live in tenses. This utter, immediate presence is the sadvastu. So this sukshma sharira, that also can be disintegrated, provided we practice this. And then the third karan sharira. Because the sadvastu atma is other than these three shariras. What is karan sharira? Incomplete knowledge can be destroyed only by complete knowledge. See? Like all of us are made out of the same pancha mahabhutas. It's not that, you know, ladies are made out of 3.5 pancha mahabhutas and gents are made out of 5.5 pancha mahabhutas. Mahatmas are made out of dozens of mahabhutas. And, you know, papi are made out of only 2, 2.5 like that. No. Body-wise, we are all the same. Sense organs-wise, we are the same. It's not the wise man sees through the eyes and otherwise sees through the ears. No, same. Same way, all the modifications of the body are common to all of them. Therefore, either this body I am not, or all the bodies I am. Only this body I am, other bodies I am not, is ignorance, incomplete knowledge. And because of this incomplete knowledge, the problems happen. And in the deep sleep, when we disown our own body, that time there is no sense of otherness. And when there is no sense of otherness, there is no desire, there is no Mr. Somebody, and there is only bliss. See, therefore, this incomplete knowledge can be discarded by proper understanding. It is for this purpose we have to study scriptures. See? Tad vijnanartham guru meva vigachet samit panihi shrotriyam brahmanishtam. So in this manner, that which is beyond the three bodies is called as the atma, the sadvastu. Second thing, panchakoshatitaha san. The same three bodies are also referred by the five panchakoshas. The gross body and annamaya kosha is the same. The karan deha, the causal body and anandamaya kosha is the same. The subtle body is indicated by the three koshas. The pranamaya kosha, the manomaya kosha and the vijnanamaya kosha. Annamaya kosha is made out of the food that is consumed by the parents, converted into seeds. A zygote is born. That's why it's called as kid, children are called as kids, because the first thing goat, zygote. So the zygote is born, and that zygote also starts first sucking the blood of the mother, then sucking the milk and destroying the food afterwards. See? So it is born out of food, maintained in food, ultimately becomes food for somebody. Therefore, this is called as annamaya kosha. Maya means modification. So our body is nothing but the modification of the food. In Bhagavad Mahapurana, something good is said. Our body is made out of that food which is, if it is left at room temperature for 5, 6, 8 hours, it gets rotten. If that is the material of which our food is made, to expect that the body should remain eternally good is the folly in understanding. Therefore, let the gross body take its own turn, use it as much as you can, afterward discard it. Why hold on to that? Second thing, the karan sharira, the incomplete knowledge about ourselves, is the same causal body and the anandamaya kosha. Then, in case of the subtle body, these three, prana, mind and the intellect. These three things together is called as the subtle body. So either you call panchakoshas or you call the three bodies, meaning is the same. There is no difference whatsoever. Thereafter, we were told avasthatraya sakshi, the one which is illuminating all the three experiences. With the gross body, we have got a waking experience. With the subtle body, we have got the dream experience. With the causal body, we have got the deep sleep experience. But there is one common denominator who is supporting the waking experiences of the waker, but never becomes the waker. Supports the dream experiences of the dreamer, but never becomes a dreamer. Supports the deep sleep experience of total absence of everything, yet which is never absent. That eternal presence, which is supporting all the three kinds of experiences, standing apart, not getting influenced by any one of them, that is avasthatraya sakshi san, that is our essential nature. Friends, the moment you get disturbed, depressed, frustrated, instead of running to the psychiatrist or taking drugs, just for 2 moments sit down and find out who is miserable. You will come to know there is somebody who is miserable. See, as a man we are never miserable. As a husband we can never be happy. As a man we are never miserable. As a father we are always disturbed. So who is husband, who is father? They are not real. Reality is man. The day you discover this principle, the moment you have become disturbed, immediately find out who is miserable. Oh, husband is miserable. Hey, chup. In a fraction of a second, your problems will be dissolved. Don't become anybody. Remain as nobody. On one t-shirt I read, I am nobody. Backside, nobody is happy. That means I am happy. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम।